We're refitting this Pearson Triton, and one of the things we have to do is to replace all of the old plumbing, seacocks, hoses, and put in new. After removing all the old seacocks, we've installed a 1-inch seacock here for the galley sink drain, and that's the only seacock we're going to have on the boat. Back here, these holes are original factory for cockpit draining. Okay, up on deck here, the water normally drains through the scupper here at the aft side. And when you want to collect rainwater here, you just put a rubber stopper or rag into the scupper, and that'll divert the water into the rain catch. Got a through-deck fitting marlon and a shutoff valve, a set for each side of the boat on the side decks, and that's going to be the rainwater collection. So one will go under here, and then the hose will be led down underneath this locker and come out in here, and then it can be directed into a jug inside the cabin. I had to take the handle off to get the thing to tighten on and then put the handle on later. Most of the hose I used on this boat is one of two types: the Shields marine hose, either the number 148 vinyl hose, which is stiffer and resists kinking when you bend it in a tight radius. It's a little more heavy duty. And the other hose is number 162 polyester reinforced clear PVC tubing, they call it. And you can bend this pretty good too, but it can collapse and flatten over time, especially if you bend it to too tight of a radius. Some of these hoses are quite impossible to fit onto the hose barb fittings because they're too tight. What I do is I apply a little multi-caulk onto the barb fitting, spread it around. You don't want it hanging off the tip there, and then heat the hose. You don't want to overheat it because then you damage the hose and won't be strong. But just heat it so that you can still touch it, but you feel it's a little bit soft. And then it slides on easy. So the multi-caulk does two things. It lubricates the fitting so that the hose can slide on, and it adds a seal so that when the hose clamp is on, if there's any chance of a leak, it's not going to leak past the caulking. We've got the plumbing finished on this Pearson Triton refit, so I'll give you a look from bow to stern, starting up in the chain locker. All these lockers in the V-berth are watertight lockers. They're going to have gasketed latches on them. In the chain locker, down at the bottom, we've got a through hole that drains aft into the bilge. And up here is a screen over the end of a 5/8 hose, which goes through the bulkhead there to the water tank vent. Here in this forward locker, the water tank vent comes through that chain locker bulkhead and goes into the top of the water tank. And then here is the chain locker drain, which goes down underneath the water tank and out the other side. I covered the construction of this integral water tank in an earlier video, But here you can see there's the baffles in it. And underneath the baffles at the bottom, which you can't see, is the chain locker drain hose. It runs underneath there. And it comes out there. Also, this is the water tank outlet. Here is where you fill the forward water tank, as well as check the level on it. Then these two hoses for the water tank outlet and the chain locker drain continue down here in the forward bilge. And there you can see it coming through to the aft part of the bilge. So down at the bottom is a valve to drain the forward bilge into the aft bilge. In case you want to keep things dry forward, you don't have to let bilge water flow up there. And I've also got a valve here for the chain locker drain. There. And this hose tail on the end lets you pull the end up to blow air back into it in case you want to check if there's any obstruction in the hose. And then the cockpit lockers also drain with these shutoff valves here and here, port and starboard. And again, hose tails so you can blow in and clear them. And there's the electric bilge pump. And there's a handle here that you can retrieve it with. And behind it is the manual bilge pump pickup. And then after that is a clear hose, which is the sight tube for the aft water tank level. And the aft tank is built in to the aft end of the bilge. And once we fill it, we'll mark off some marks for every 5 gallons or so that you can check the level. Here you can see that level comes into the aft tank at the top. And we've also got the manual bilge pump here. And then its plumbing runs out and aft through the cockpit locker there. And on the other side, we've got the aft tank fill. Here is the tank vent. And here is the half-inch hose that has a pickup tube going down to the bottom of the tank. There. That delivers the water through this manifold here, the forward tank and the aft tank can be shut off or turned on and directed to the center, which is the foot pump inlet. And then from the foot pump outlet, comes up here to the inside of the water filter, then out of the water filter, and to the spout here for the sink. And then this one and only seacock on the boat is for the sink drain coming up there. That water filter is a charcoal cartridge in a Glacier Bay household water filter system from Home Depot. And that's the tool to change the elements. Then here you can see the rainwater collection on the deck. It comes down through the aft end of the dish locker into this galley locker. And even though I have a shutoff valve at the top, I also have a shutoff valve on the other side of the hose. And you can then place this into a bucket or a water jug to fill with rainwater. And there's the other one is on the port side in that little locker there, and coiled up, ready to use there under the nav table. This is the port cockpit locker drain and the starboard, and these hoses cross and then come into the bilge where the shutoff valves were, so that you can either keep them closed to keep the cockpit lockers as watertight compartments, or drain them as needed if they get water in them. And then in the cockpit, there is a deck drain there, and the cockpit area drain, as well as the footwell drains down at the bottom. They come inside here on each side. Kind of tight in here. There's the deck drain. These are 1-inch hoses. That's a cockpit seat drain. They come into this manifold here, which also picks up the cockpit footwell drain. And there's a solid fiberglass tube there to overboard. And down the bottom is a through-hole fitting to drain this locker, which is a watertight locker. Other hoses coming up through here. This is the aft water tank fill. Got a deck fill there. And the three-quarter hose runs aft to the lazarette locker for discharge. And on the other side is the manual bilge pump outlet. Normally you'd want to have a seacock to drain the cockpit here, but in this case we've kept the original fiberglass tube that the factory installed, and we've reinforced it heavily with more fiberglass, and we've added this bulkhead right next to it to make it a watertight locker sealed off from the bilge. So if there ever was any damage or leakage here, it's contained in this locker and can be drained into the bilge when you're ready to. And so that means that normally you'd be leery of having a cockpit connected to the hull with a fiberglass tube that's rigid in case there's any flexing going on. But in this case, because we've got the bulkheads right up on each side of the tube close by, and because it's a watertight locker, there is no danger there. And also, if you want to store heavy things like anchors down here and you're worried about maybe damaging that tube, even though it's very heavily glassed, a little wooden removable box could be put around it. The lazarette locker is now a tilt-up outboard well locker. There you can see the three-quarter hose coming through that bulkhead. And instead of putting another through hull through the side of the boat, we've drained it right into the aft end of this lazarette, which is a free-flooding outboard well. And on this side is the inch-and-a-half hose outlet from the manual bilge pump. So water can come in and drain out here through the cracks and the boards down there around the outboard well. And that's a pretty basic plumbing system for a 28-foot boat.